best and best of the songs of the morning, dawn out our darkness and lend us thine aid. Star of the east, the horizon adorning, shining, low lies his head with the beats of the soul. Angels adore him in slumber reclining, maker and monarch and savior of all. Say, shall we yield him in costly devotion, odors of Edom and offerings divine, gems of the mountains and pearls of the ocean, myrrh from the forest or gold from the mine? Vainly we offer each oblation, vainly with gifts would his favor secure. Richer by far is the heart's adoration, dearer to God are the prayers of the poor. Brightest and best of the sons of the morning, dawn on our darkness and lend us thine aid. Star of the east, the horizon adorning, guide where our infant Redeemer is laid.
Good morning and welcome everybody to St. Andrew's Church. A very happy new year to you all. Today we celebrate the feast of the Epiphany. We recall the visit of the wise men, how God revealed Jesus to be his son at his baptism in the River Jordan, and Jesus' first miracle when he turns water into wine at the wedding in Cana and Galilee. During the service, we will have opportunity to reflect upon those events as we listen to our three gospel readings. And then we will have an opportunity to renew our own baptismal vows and commit ourselves at the beginning of this new year to walking with our Lord and Saviour, shining as a light for him and seeking to make him known. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Three wonders mark this holy day. This day, Jesus is revealed as the Christ in the waters of baptism. Alleluia. This day, a star leads the wise men to the Christ child. Alleluia. This day, water is made wine at the wedding feast. Alleluia. And so as we meet around the font this morning, we are reminded this day Jesus is revealed as the Christ in the waters of baptism. I will take you from the nations and gather you from all countries. I will sprinkle clean water upon you and purify you from all defilement. A new heart I will give you and put a new spirit within you. You shall be my people, and I shall be your God. Tina will now bring our first gospel reading.
This day a star leads the wise men to the manger. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. glory to you, O Lord. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may go also and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Eternal Father, who at the baptism of Jesus revealed him to be your Son, anointing him with the Holy Spirit, grant to us who are born again by water and the Spirit that we may be faithful to our calling as your adopted children, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give him thanks and praise. God in Christ gives us water welling up for eternal life. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. Lord, give us this water, and we shall thirst no more. It is indeed right, it is our duty and our joy at all times to give you thanks and praise. For today, the grace of the Holy Spirit, in the form of a dove, descended upon the waters. Therefore, Heavenly Father, accept our sacrifice of praise, and by the power of your life-giving Spirit, sanctify these waters of your new creation, that we, with all who have been born anew by water and the Spirit, may be renewed in your image, walk by the light of faith, and serve you in holiness of life. Through your anointed Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom with you and the Holy Spirit we lift our voice of praise. Blessed be God, our strength and our salvation, now and forever. Amen. In baptism, God calls us out of darkness into his marvellous light. To follow Christ means dying to sin and rising to new life with him. And so we take a moment of quiet reflection as we think about the responses that we will make. Do you turn to Christ? I turn to Christ. Do you repent of your sins? I repent of my sins. Do you renounce evil? I renounce evil. And so, brothers and sisters, I ask you to profess the faith of the Church. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God's Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world. We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So if you would like to join with me now as we renew our baptism vows. Almighty God, we thank you for our fellowship in the household of faith with all who have been baptized into your name. Keep us faithful to our baptism, and so make us ready for that day when the whole creation shall be made perfect in your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. May Christ dwell in your hearts through faith, that you may be rooted and grounded in love and bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. Amen. Martin will now read from the Gospel of Matthew.
We now hear how the King of all the world is revealed to the Magi. This day a star leads the wise men to the manger. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising, and have come to pay him homage." Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child and Mary his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. May I be helped to speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. There's something about journeying that I really like. Not the tedious motorway driving kind of experience, but something else, something where somebody else is in control of the transport, like a long train journey. It becomes a sort of mini adventure, especially if it involves restaurant car meals on the train or even sleeping on board. There are, of course, slower means of transport available. Jane and I used to do walking tours, but have now moved on to cycling tours, both of which are enjoyable because you're in control of the journey with a map and directions. Although getting lost, which has happened on more than one occasion, is also, I would say, part of the experience. There's always an element within me, though, that's looking forward to it being over. And that's for a couple of reasons. Firstly, I like to relive these experiences, thinking and talking over what happened and studying the photos. The other reason, I believe, comes from wanting to tell other people about the adventure. Not to boast about what we did, but to share an enjoyable experience with others. In my view, there's a difference between journeying and travelling. Journeying's a more rounded, a more complete experience. You gather things along the way, you meet people, you have relatable experiences. A journey is an adventure, whereas travelling is simply getting from A to B. For a group of wise men from the East, journeying would have been quite a different experience. Sometimes we travel too speedily to take in what's around us, but this certainly wouldn't have been a problem for them. It would have been a real adventure with preparation, provisioning, working out where to stay or to pitch tents, considering how to stay safe. It may have been a complicated journey to organise, but they have a single purpose, with a guiding light to follow as it leads them to a child. They're warned not to go back to Herod after they've presented their precious gifts, but then they face the return journey and disappear from the biblical record. But that isn't journey's end, so what happens to them afterwards? Who do they tell when they arrive home, and what do they say about the climax of their journey? And what's the reaction of those they tell? There are several traditions surrounding the wise men, the first of which is that there were three of them, as many as 12 according to the Eastern Church, and that their names were Caspar, Melchior and Balthazar, although there are name variations too. However, these names don't appear in any manuscript until about 500 years later. It's also a tradition that they returned to Jerusalem later and were martyred there. Their bodies were apparently later transported to Milan, where they were kept in the cathedral. That is, until it was plundered in the 12th century, with the relics ending up in Cologne Cathedral. And there are many more traditions and customs in various countries associated with them and with their visit. Whatever you may think of the historical accuracy of these traditions, it suggests a real curiosity about what does happen to them, and that their role or purpose in the Messiah's story doesn't end at the stable. We have all been on a journey this last year, and I wonder how much of it you are keen to tell others about. There's nobody in this country, and across most of the globe, that hasn't experienced a virus journey. So who is there to tell? Perhaps our grandchildren or great-grandchildren, if they've not been old enough to experience it themselves. It may seem to have been quite a static year with lockdowns and cancelled plans, but we have all been on a journey of discovering who we are and what matters to us family-wise and Christian family-wise. It's been a journey of finding out what we can do and what God-given skills we can develop. But we've also been on other journeys, in part as a consequence of the virus. We've journeyed to different arrangements for gathering for worship. We've journeyed with technology and have enjoyed some terrific work as we've seen people in their homes and heard from so many more people. We've journeyed to new weekday connections in prayer and study together. And we've journeyed to a place of regular communication with those who haven't been able to gather with us, checking they're okay and passing on God's message of love and hope. We've also journeyed to a place of knowing each other better and of getting to know members of our community that we didn't really know before. So we are closer to each other now. This is something we can carry with us into our common future as we work towards making our small part of Christ's journeying community a fit place to encounter Jesus in the 21st century and beyond. The journey of the Magi doesn't end with them locating and revering the Christ child with the hugely symbolic gifts they present. It's also about a group of Gentiles journeying to the manger and then journeying out from it. It's the first indicator in the gospel story that the message of God's gift of his son is intended as a gift to the whole world, Jew and Gentile alike. What do you imagine they talked about on those long days and nights on the road? Wasn't the traffic bad on the Jerusalem to Damascus highway? They have reached their goal and seen the amazing event they journeyed to see. Surely on their return they tell somebody, many people perhaps, what they have seen and who they've met. Knowledge such as this is surely for sharing. Based on the foundation of the accompanied journey we've all travelled, where we go from here is the next question. We've all travelled to the manger, so after we presented our gifts to God and caught our breath, we travel from the manger. We too have a story to tell about Jesus with us, about God's great love for us, and about the journey we've been on. In some ways, it's a journey that's only just begun. Amen.
I wonder if you managed to see the bright star shining in the sky that we were all anticipating. Sadly, it was a bit cloudy, wasn't it, in this area? So I think unless you had a telescope, we might not have been able to see. But we're reminded now of the wise men who journeyed far, following that star, bringing them to the place where Jesus, Mary, and Joseph were. And so we're going to place those wise men in the crib now. The first wise man who brings his gold to Jesus. And so we pray. Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe. To you be praise and glory forever. As gold in the furnace is tried and purified seven times in the fire, we pray that you will purify our hearts and our minds, that we may be a royal priesthood, acceptable in the service of your kingdom. Blessed be God forever. And so the wise man who brought his incense to Jesus. Blessed are you, Lord, our God, King of the universe. To you be praise and glory forever. As our prayer rises up before you as incense, so may we be presented before you with penitent hearts and uplifted hands to offer ourselves in your priestly service. Blessed be God forever. And our final wise man who brings the gift of myrrh. Blessed are you, Lord, our God and King of the universe. To you be praise and glory forever. As you give medicine to heal our sickness, and the leaves of the tree of life for the healing of the nations, we pray now that you would so anoint us with your healing power, that we may be the first fruits of your new creation. Blessed be God forever. And we continue now in prayer. Let us pray. Let us worship our Saviour with joy and make our prayer to our Heavenly Father. The Magi came from the east to worship your Son. Father, grant to Christians everywhere the spirit of adoration. And as we gaze upon that crib, Let us be willing to kneel before our Saviour and offer him the gift of ourselves. Lord of glory, hear our prayer. The infant Christ received gifts of gold, incense and myrrh. Father, accept the offering of our hearts and minds. At the beginning of this year, let us turn our minds to our gifts in creation and prepare to use them to glorify God in the world. Lord, we pray that you would give us opportunities to serve you. And as we continue to worship together in different ways, we pray that you would give us confidence to serve you in our community, to be your light and life, to offer welcome to those that we meet, and to do so not in our own strength, but by the power of your Holy Spirit. Lord of glory, hear our prayer. The kingdoms of this world have become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ. Father, grant an abundance of peace to your world. We pray especially for those countries where there is conflict and warfare. We bring to mind the faces of people, men, women and children we see on our television news. We pray for them. We pray that they would know your presence and that peace would be at the forefront of their minds. That in the hopelessness they so often feel, their hope would be in you, the Saviour of the world. Lord of glory, hear our prayer. The Holy Family lived in exile and in the shadow of death. Father, we ask that you would look in mercy on all who are poor and powerless, and all who suffer. In the quietness of our hearts, we bring to God those countries, those peoples, those situations where God's presence is needed. We think about people in our own country at this time who, on top of COVID and all that we've had to cope with this year, now find themselves homeless because their homes have been flooded. Those without power. And we continue to pray as the virus increases that those who are in greatest need would know your presence with them now. We give you thanks for those who have supported the most vulnerable throughout this Christmas season. And we pray that you would give us that grace to offer our gifts to help those in most need at this time. And again, we pray for our government and indeed for the leaders of the nations of the world, that they would seek the common good and might never forget the poor and the weakest in their care. Lord of glory, hear our prayer. Your Son, as both human and divine, shared the life of his home and family at Nazareth. Father, protect in your love our neighbours, our families, and this community of which we are a part. We pray for this community and in Chelvey and Brockley, and all who are worshipping you today, who haven't yet found peace in your name. And in the silence, we remember now before God those whom we carry in our hearts. Lord of glory, hear our prayer. Father, we rejoice in our fellowship with the shepherds, the angels, the Magi, Mary and Joseph, and of all the faithful departed. In your unfailing love for us and for all people, we ask you to hear and answer our prayers through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. The angels sang of peace on earth, goodwill to all. And so, although we're parted, we share now and celebrate God's presence with us and that gift of peace which he offers us all. Our Saviour Christ is the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace, there shall be no end. And may we hold fast to that promise in this coming year. So may the peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you.
What child is this who laid to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping? Who made us greet with comfort sweet while shepherds watch a keeping? This is Christ the King, whom shepherds worship and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him praise, the babe, the Son of Mary. Why lies he in such mean estate, where ox and ass are feeding? Come, have no fear, come, Son is here, his love, full love's exceeding. Now the Spirit shall bless him through, a cross be born for me, for you. Hail, hail the Saviour comes, the babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him east and scold at war, all tongues and peoples on him. The King of Kings salvation brings, let every heart enthrone him. With gracious song on high, while Mary sings a lullaby. Joy, joy, for Christ is born, the babe, the Son of Mary.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. On the third day there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine gave out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what concern is that to you and me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now standing there were six stone water jars for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to them, "Fill the jars with water," and they filled them up to the brim. He said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the chief steward." So they took it. When the steward tasted the water that had become wine and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the steward called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first, and then the inferior wine after the guests have become drunk. But you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this, the first of his signs in Cana of Galilee, and revealed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. And so we pray, Almighty God, in Christ you make all things new. Transform the poverty of our nature by the riches of your grace, and in the renewal of our lives, make known your heavenly glory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And so as we share together in bread and wine, we remember that God so loved the world that he gave his only Son to be our Saviour. And wherever you may be today, as we worship together, may you know Jesus' presence, and may you feed on him, the bread of life. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Lord of all life, you created the universe where all living things reflect your glory. You give us this great and beautiful earth to discover and cherish. By the leading of a star, you have revealed your only Son to the world, that in following him, we are led from darkness into his marvelous light. You made us all, each wonderfully different, to join with the angels as we praise you together. We say, "Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." We thank you, loving Father, because when we turned away, you sent Jesus, your Son. He gave his life for us on the cross and shows us the way to live. Send your Holy Spirit that these gifts of bread and wine may be for us Christ's body and his blood. On the night before he died, when darkness had fallen, Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After they had eaten, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my blood, poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins." So, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate his love, his death, his risen life. As you feed us with these gifts, send your Holy Spirit and change us more and more to be like Jesus, our Saviour. Help us, Father, to love one another as we look forward to that day when suffering is ended and all creation is gathered in your loving arms. And now with Mary and all your saints, we give you glory through Jesus Christ, in the strength of the Spirit, today and forever. Amen. Believing in the promises of God, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break the bread of life, and that life is the light of the world. God, here among us, light in the midst of us, bringing us, each of us, to light and to life. Christ is the true bread which has come down from heaven. Lord, give us this bread always. Body of Christ. The blood of Christ. Remember, in the bleak midwinter, what can I give him, poor as I am? What he wants so much is our hearts. May he fill your hearts with his joy and his love and his peace today and always. Lord God, the bright splendour whom the nations seek, may we who with the wise men have been drawn by your light, discern the glory of your presence in your Son, the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Is
So as our service ends, we pray for God's blessing upon us. And as we go into 2021, as we all know, we don't know, but we know that God is faithful and walks with us every step of the way. So may you be filled with that knowledge of his love for you. May God the Father, who led the wise men by the shining of a star to find the Christ, the light from light, lead you also in your pilgrimage to find the Lord. Amen. May God the Son, who turned water into wine at the wedding feast at Cana, transform your lives and make glad your hearts. Amen. May God the Holy Spirit, who came upon the beloved Son at his baptism in the River Jordan, pour out his gifts on you who have come to the waters of new birth. Amen. We have seen his glory, the glory revealed to all the nations. So go in peace and in joy to love and to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, Amen.